Hello everybody, my name's Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build my silent, randomized 1-bit multiplexer. You can see here right in front of you. So as you can see here, it's possible to cascade this design to get, for example, a 2-bit randomizer. As you can see here at the 4 different outputs here. So as always, let's start with a little demonstration. Here we have the input, and as already mentioned, 4 outputs. And once I activate the input, one of those outputs gets turned on, and which one is completely random and can't be predicted at all. So that's basically what the thing here is for. So what can you use this for? For example, if you have a puzzle or some kind of machine and you only want to activate one of those outputs, but you don't want to give the player a way to predict which one, this is some thing you can use for this intention. So that's that. Now let's talk about the size requirements. One module or one multiplexer is basically 4 blocks long, 5 blocks if you count the blocks you need to interconnect with the next rows, with the next modules. Then it's 3 blocks wide and a total of 2 blocks high. So it's pretty compact. And resource-wise, you will need at least a few normal blocks, then 3 redstone dust, 2 redstone repeaters, 1 comparator, 1 dropper, and 1 hopper. And then I'm using a lever here as an input. Of course, this can be another circuit altogether. And then for interconnecting with the next rows, with the next module, you might need some additional redstone and redstone repeaters. And then for the actual randomizer, you will need a non-stackable block and a stackable block. So, for example, a tool or a weapon or a minecart or something along those lines that are put in those droppers here. But anyway, that's basically what this thing is for and what you need. So all that's left is showing you how to build this randomizer here. So starting from the input, start placing your dropper facing upwards like this and the hopper facing downwards right on top like that. Then take an output with a comparator from the hopper, run this into a normal block, then place 2 blocks to either side like this, place 3 more blocks like that, grab your 2 repeaters, place them like this, and then finally place down 3 redstone dust, and finally place 1 non-stackable item and 1 stackable item into the dropper here. And that's basically all of the mechanic, or all of the circuit. So for now, let's place 2 lamps like this, and then let's try this out. And as you can see, now this has been activated, and now this has activated. And basically, this is how the 1-bit randomizer works. And if you want to cascade this, so if you want to use, for example, 4 exits, all you have to do is basically use a repeater on this point here and a redstone on this point here. And then from there on you basically just build the same. Just in this case, as you can see, we can't have them this input running into the middle of this. But what is also possible is that we can place it basically at this point here. So once you have the comparator, run this again into a normal block, and then place 2 blocks to this side and 2 blocks to this side here, then 3 blocks like that, and again we place our repeaters, and as you can see here, it's basically the same, just now this raised block here is right behind this repeater there. And that's basically all of that. So now let's just finish the exits, the outputs of this circuit. And let's put some light right there. And of course, now you will have to put some items into those droppers. So put in a normal item and a non-stackable item. And then, as you can see, you have your, in this case, 2-bit randomizer. And that's basically how you can build a silent version of a randomized 1-bit multiplexer. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and, well, see ya!